Good morning. So today I wanted to go live for a number of reasons, but the main reason is for those of you who haven't joined us in our Zoom calls in the morning, this is an opportunity to see if maybe this is something you'd like to join in on. So the first thing that we usually do is draw an intention card for the day. So we've actually finished this deck. It's words of the day and affirmations. So I'm going to open it back up and pick one for us today. And the word of the day, cool, is a little wolf. And the word of the day is trust. So it says, it's called your life purpose because it will take a lifetime to fulfill. So the word is trust. And it says it's called your life's purpose because it will take a lifetime to fulfill. So that's our word of the day. And then we draw a super attractor card. And this one says, when I introduce joy to a situation, I change the vibrational frequency of what's happening around me. And that's our other card. And then after this, I'm going to share my screen and we're going to stretch. So this is a 7-minute
video. So the first move that we're going to do is a slow head roll to the right. So it's going to look like this. A nice, slow head roll. And then once your chin reaches the bottom, we're going to do a slow head roll to the left. From there, we look up and we open up the shoulders. Swing them out and up and then in and up to an X. Out and up, in, and to the X. After four of those, we move right into the hug stretch for eight. And this is always a really fun move, so just nice and easy. Just flow with this. Now, after eight of those, we're gonna reach for the sky. We bring our hands down to our thighs, and then we touch our toes. And we come back up to the thighs, down to the toes, up to the thighs, and down to the toes. So we're going to go reach and touch and touch and touch. After the second one, we drop down and we slowly roll it up one vertebrae at a time. Once we're back upright and standing, we're going to step out to the side and we're going to rotate up and just let your eyes follow your fingers. We're going to do this four times to the right. And after the fourth time, we bring it back to center, and we step out to the left. Again, let your eyes follow your fingers. And notice as I'm rotating my feet as well, up onto the balls of my feet. Once we're done with those four, we're going to bring it back to center. From here, we're going to march it out, just like that. Eight times each leg. There's five, six, seven, and eight. From here, we're going to step out to the side. We're going to kick one foot back while we bring our arms up and overhead. So we're going to kick it back and kick it back. And this is a great little stretch warming up those quads. There you go. We're going to do this eight times. And after the eighth time, we do a big stretch up, big chest stretch. We bring it back to the center. And then we open it up, Superman style. This is where we're gonna get super tight. I want you to tighten up all the muscles in your body. We're gonna take a big, powerful step forward with your right foot, and we're gonna squeeze it, and we're gonna press. We're gonna bring it back. We're gonna then switch it over to the left foot. Big, powerful step forward and press. Bring it back. Now we're gonna take it out to the right side. We're gonna lunge out to the side, squeeze it up, squeezing those shoulders. Press it back to the center, out to the left. Squeeze it up again. Now we're going to take these lunges back. Take powerful lunge back, press overhead. Again, keeping every muscle in your body super tight, super strong. And once we're back here to the center, that's what we call the star lunge. Forward, forward, side, side, back, back. We're gonna jog it out. There we go. And then we slowly pick up those knees. And then we're gonna move into the squat and reach and squat and reach. We're gonna do this four times. There we go. And fourth time. Now we're gonna move into what we call Phoenix squats. We bring our hands together all the way overhead. We're gonna do four of these and we're almost done. There's number three and here's the fourth. And now we're gonna throw in a bonus one. There's a fifth one we're gonna do, but in this one we're gonna do super slow because it's the very end of the Move 1 Million routine. And at the very top, we bring it back down to the guns. We have a lot of fun with this. And at the very end, you can hit a pose. Any pose you wanna do, you can point it to the sky. You can do the Phoenix here, or you can even drop it right back down to Move 1 Million. There you go. So from here, let's add some music, let's bring in some friends, and let's have some fun.
All right, we're actually not gonna play some music and move in some friends because then it won't play. it'll be like a copyright thing. So, beautiful to see that. Powerful word for me. I'm working on trusting myself and others. Something that's come into my world with trust is just to try to stay present. Because if you're worrying about the future or dwelling on the past, it's hard to trust, right? And I found this through one of our members, Marissa. I think she might be friends with him or came across him. I think he was inspired to do this through his weight loss. I know his song was at least. But to move 1 million, and that's the routine that we've been doing pretty much every day for the past month. So after that, we're going to actually jump into our priming. And the reason why we stretch before priming is just to get the juices flowing and to get us a little, sometimes if we jump on the call right away, we're just waking up. So for those of you who don't know who Tony Robbins is, he does a priming every day. And this is one of the things I love most about our morning routine because it encompasses not only gratitude, but meditation, healing, self-healing, breath work, and gratitude. I'm not sure if I said that. So it's one of my favorite things to do in the morning. So we're going to go ahead and play the video. And this is actually my favorite video. And if sometimes when I open my eyes for a second to see if maybe somebody joined the call, I'll see like a visual of something he's talking about and I could go even deeper within. So if you're going to join me in the priming, just make sure that you're breathing through your nose only. And you're going to start with your hands up and just breathe through your nose, sit in a quiet place, maybe, you know, dim the light. And you're just going to breathe through your nose like this. Just through your nose. So I'm gonna play his priming video. Let's see. Oh, can you see my screen? Stop screen. Let's see. Share screen. Okay.
Feel centered, feet flat on the ground, back straight, they're comfortable, nothing on your lap. And we're going to start by 3 sets of 10 breathing. Close your eyes, hands come up, here we go. Stop. flat on your lap, and up. Just notice what you feel. You feel some tingling anywhere in your body? You feel relaxed? Maybe you have a little sense of peace? So notice what you feel and appreciate it, whatever it is. Little or big doesn't matter. Little is ideal. All right, your eyes stay closed. We're going to three more sets of 10. Here we go. Stop. Palms face up on your lap. Relax. Just notice what you feel. Feeling tingling. Feel relaxed. Give you a sense of peace. Three more sets of 10. Eyes closed. Here we go. Breathe hard out the nose. Up and out. Ourselves three gifts, three moments of our life we can feel grateful for one at a time and relive them. Feel the beauty of it, the joy, the gratitude. Think of a moment now you could be grateful for, a little moment or a big moment. Could have been years ago, could have been today, could have been weeks ago. Step into a moment you truly could feel grateful for. That's it. Step in your body as if you were there. See what you saw then now. Hear what you heard then now. That's it. That's it. Feel what you're feeling. Just fill up with the gratitude of that moment. Breathe the way you breathe when it feels so good. You might even have an inner smile that may show up on your face. You never know. Just take it in and feel so grateful. Give yourself the gift. Perfect. Enjoy it. Think of a second moment now you can feel deeply grateful for it. Step into that moment as you think of it. It could be a little moment or a big one, but anything you can feel really grateful for. Experience it like it's happening right now. I feel so grateful for that moment, the blessing of that moment. Beauty of it. Think of a third moment now that you could feel so grateful for if you really wanted to now. It's a special moment you're grateful for. That's it. That's it. See what you saw, like you're there. Hear what you heard, what someone said to you, or what you said to yourself. Breathe and feel the way you were feeling then, now. Fill up with the gratitude. Give yourself a gift. That's it. Perfect. Perfect. Just enjoy. Revel. Feel the inner smile. joy, appreciation, and love. And now we're going to take 3 minutes and do that little blessing and prayer. Imagine as you breathe, you're taking in white light, gold light, ice blue light from the top of your head, like coming out of the universe through the crown of your head. As it comes down, as you breathe it in, it goes through your brain, and it cleanses, it washes, it heals your mind, your body, your emotions, your relationships, your life. As it comes down through the chest, down through the stomach, the legs, into the earth, and then back up again, releasing it back into the sky. Bring it down again, that energy. All of it down through the legs of the ground. Back up again. Bring it down. Filling it up, making the best part of you stronger, more alive, more love, more joy, more gratitude. Bring it back out. Healing, strengthening the best parts of you, your courage, your love, your passion, and all the way out again. Down the head, neck, chest, shoulders, stomach, legs, feet into the ground, the center of the earth, and coming back up the legs, through the chest, up the top of the head. One more, do one more. Enjoy it. Now bring it down into your heart, and this time send it like a circle out. Pour it into those you love most and feel them healing. Their mind, their body, their emotions, their fears, their angers heal. The best part of them being strengthened, their love, their courage, their compassion, their joy. And you feel it fills them up, and you see the light fill them up, and you see them smile or feel their joy. Have the circle expand, bring it back down through you into your heart again, and then send it out further. Family, friends, partners, co-workers, strangers that are lit up by you sending energy into them. They don't even have to know it. Bring it down again. Put it through your whole body and all the way through your legs into the earth. Back up again. Another one from the top through you, healing your mind, your body, your emotions, cleansing it, strengthening you, the best parts of you, your passion, your love, your determination, your joy, and bring it back out again. Bring it to your heart and send it again to those you love and those you know that are beginning to love now. Healing them, strengthening them. They don't even know it. It feels so good to give to them, to see them feel joy, see them heal. Take in the joy that you could give to them. They don't even know it. And then one more time, your whole body, yourself, into the earth, and back up through you, up into space. Strengthening the best parts of you. Real you. Without fear. Without worry. Now we do the third step of priming. Three to thrive. What are the three outcomes, three goals that you are no longer goals? You're going to experience them as done. You're going to celebrate the victory. See it, feel like it's done, and giving thanks, gratitude that it's happened to yourself, to those that helped you, to the universe or God. Start with one and step in like it's already happened. And you feel the excitement, the joy in you. You're celebrating it. It's done. Yeah, that's it. Take in the whole victory. Feel it. Breathe it. Give thanks for it. It's done. It's happened. You're living it. It's not a dream anymore. It's a dream you're living. That's it. Great. Great. Perfect. That's it. Think of a second victory now, a second goal or outcome that's no longer a goal. You're experiencing it as done. You're full of excitement and gratitude. You're celebrating that it's done, that you made it happen, whatever it was you're after. A significant goal you want to achieve in the next 6, 12 months, 3 weeks, next week, you can pick anything, but something that will be a great victory, and you're not wondering, you're not hoping, you're not asking. It is done, and you're celebrating it with gratitude, joy. Feel it. Perfect. Perfect. Enjoy it. Yes, give thanks for it. I need one more, third to thrive. It's the third outcome, goal, result, and now it's a result. You've done it. You're in it celebrating the victory as it's happened. And you're seeing the impact for yourself and others you care for. And you're so grateful for it all, that it's done, that it finally happened, that you made it happen, that you were guided to make it happen, that you did your part, and you were guided. Feel how great it is for you and for others. Now with your eyes closed, reach out with your right hand and grab any moment in your life you're proud of. Any moment, a little moment of being proud, or a big moment. Bring it in your heart as it touches your heart. Yes! And feel it explode in your heart like you're there, that proud moment once again. And feel it connect to the things you're grateful for. So you feel it all at once. Think of another moment in your life you can feel proud about, a little moment or a big one. Proud moment, grab it, bring it in, have it touch your heart, say yes, and feel it stacking on all the other great moments you've already put in your heart today. You're awakened in your heart, they're already there. Think of a moment of love, or romance, or sensuality. From your past, grab a great moment, bring that in your heart, shout yes inside. Feel it, enjoy it. Think of a future moment of romance or sensuality that will come. A future moment that will be so exciting and beautiful. Grab that future moment of intimacy, of joy, or love. Bring that in your heart. Say yes. Feel it explode in your heart with all its beauty, all its joy, all its love, all its excitement. Yes, that time is coming. Think of an exciting moment in your life that's already happened. The moment was really exciting. Grab that moment and relive it. Bring your heart. Say yes as it touches your heart. Feel it. Step in and feel the excitement of that moment all over again. Enjoy it. Grab a sacred moment from your life. A sacred moment. A moment you feel guided. A moment beyond your mind. Bring that moment to your heart. Say yes. Grab another exciting moment from your future, one that's coming that's going to lift you, excite you, make you feel so alive. Bring it into your heart and say yes. Now you have 20 seconds to get any moments in the past and the future, proud moments, sexy moments, loving moments, sacred moments, laughter moments, any moment in the past or future. Bring them in as fast as you want, as fast as you can. Say yes each time it gets there. Go. Stack them all together. Now just feel them all. Feel them all in your heart, your soul, your spirit, all at once. What if life was always happening for you and not to you? It looks like it's happening to you, but it's all happening for you. What if even the pain and problems were gifts, and you found the meaning and you're free of the pain? Even if today was a difficult day in your life, meaning yesterday or days before or weeks or months before, today is more compelling. And tomorrow, because of this today well-lived, will be a magnificent one. Find yourself opening your eyes when you're ready, rising up, and stretching slowly when you're ready. And start to feel the energy you build up, the energy of all these experiences, the joy, the happiness, the love, the excitement. Bring it into your heart. Feel it. Breathe it. Experience it. Own it. It's in you, as you. This is the real you. This is your true nature. Unencumbered by the survival mind. Free to be you. Free to be the real you. Breathe it. Feel its joy. Feel its love. Feel its excitement. Feel its unlimited nature. This is your spirit. This is your soul. This is you unleashed.
All right. All right. So, yeah, it is awesome that I found that. Oh, that was from earlier. So that's Priming with Tony Robbins. And you know, throughout that, he does the three to thrive. So sometimes when I'm within the priming, I'll write my three to thrive, because when I'm in that beautiful state, sometimes things come to me. And this has been a really cool just practice that we've had, where we write the three things that could take us and help us get to our main goals. I actually picked four today. And then, you know, we go into that visualization while we're in the priming, which is really fun. And sometimes a lot of us don't want to come out of it. And the next thing is we usually write down 10 things we're grateful for. And one of our group members, Stacy, a couple of days ago was saying that sometimes we just like, we'll like write the same thing, you know, over and over again. And I tend to do that sometimes. But then she was stating that, suggesting that maybe we should go a little step further and maybe really think about why we're grateful for those things. And it made me think of this book, The Magic, for those of you who haven't read it. It's a book on gratitude. And, you know, that's where I started with writing what I'm grateful for. As I don't even know how old this is, probably 3 years old. But I could just read off a few from then. I don't even know when the date of this was, but I'm grateful for the abundance in my life. I'm grateful for my life, my pain. I'm grateful for divine light. I'm grateful for connections. I'm grateful for nature. I'm grateful for my purpose. I'm grateful for learning. I'm grateful for resting. I'm grateful for my mind, and I'm grateful for my freedom. So this is a great book if you want to go a step further, because they have little lessons, and then they, you know, they encourage you to list what you're grateful for. So that was a great book. So after that, now we get into our morning motivational video. It's funny, we're already 27 minutes in, but I also wanted to state, like Tony always talks about, like you don't have to do all these things, but he talks about his priming, and I think the last one was maybe 10 to 14 minutes, and he always says if you don't have 10 to 14 minutes for yourself in the morning, that you don't have a life. We spend about an hour every morning doing these things, but I was curious to see without... you know, the conversations that we have and the mastermind that we have, how long it would take to complete this. So it's actually not, I thought maybe it would take a half hour, but it's going to go above that. All right. So I'm going to share my screen again, and we are going to watch our morning motivational video. I really, really enjoy these videos. I think the most it's Law of Attraction Coaching. So this one's 14 minutes, and I'm going to watch it with you.
How do you create your life? You get hungry for something, don't you?
I realize that when to have the level of success that I want to have, it's difficult to spread it out and do multiple things. You know, it's in order to be world class, and I made a decision, I want to be world class, and it takes such a desperate, obsessive focus to excel on a level that I want to make movies. You know, I was Star Wars when I was young. I sat in the movie theater and watched Star Wars, and I just couldn't believe that movie made me feel like that. Just floored, just stunned by the creativity. And just I'm realizing that in order to move people in that way, in order to touch people in that way, you got to focus with all of your fiber and all of your heart and all your creativity.
You may take it for granted now. Hopefully not. But it was once just a vision. This is impossible one time. So how did you do it? You started with a concrete vision of what you wanted, and you focused on it continuously, didn't you? Wherever focus goes, energy flows. You envision something, you got clear about it, and then you start thinking about all the reasons why you want it. You got excited about it. So this is what's next for me now. I want this. You may have dreamed about it, thought about it, But when you focus on something continuously, something magical happens. You get insights, don't you? Overhear a conversation, hear something you wouldn't have heard if you didn't have that outcome or goal that you wanted to manage. Who's ever come up with something, obsessed about it, didn't even know how to do it, and it just happened and it came together? Who's had that experience? Say I. So why don't we tap into that power now for the business of life? Who has done something in your life that once seemed difficult or impossible, and now it's part of your life? How did you do it? You created it three ways. Number one, you decided there's something you wanted so bad that you unleashed all your desire. You became obsessed with it. Was a business, or a car, or a relationship, or a transformation of the body? If it's something you once envisioned and now it's real, if you didn't just envision it, you brought so much emotion to it that now it's in your life. It was once a dream, it was once a goal, and now it's in your life.
I still grind. I love the grind. If you're competing in one of my businesses, I'm going to kick your ass because I'm going to outgrind you. Right? That's what being an entrepreneur is. You've got to get out there and do the work. So when it comes to how do you learn, right? Because that's the question, how do I learn this stuff? Everybody has got to go through that process, right? I read I'm in the tech business, I'm in the media business, the entertainment business. I've got to try to prepare myself for all the Shark Tank businesses. I read 3 hours plus a day, right? Well, everybody else is getting a suntan, or even when I'm getting a suntan, I'm online or I've got books, I'm reading all I can.
It's just a matter of what's important to you. And what's important to you, for whatever reason, I didn't feel good about myself if I wasn't doing everything I could to be the best version of myself. If I felt like I left anything on the table, it would eat away at me. I wouldn't be able to look myself in the mirror. And so the reason why I can retire now and be completely comfortable about it, because I know that I've done everything I could to be the best basketball player I could be. And so, yeah, that's where it comes from for me. You can't leave any stone unturned.
They worked, okay? It wasn't about just their talent. It was about their work ethic. People knew them for their work ethic. So just ask yourself this week, do people know you for your work ethic? Are people like, man, you work hard? Are people actually commenting about you showing up early and staying late? Because if they're not, then you're just blending in with everybody else's work ethic. At the end of the day, talent will not win the game. It is work ethic that will win the game.
Well, if you don't work out, you don't get a muscle, right? So I always tell people, there's a daily practice like priming. If you don't do that, if you get up and you just have no discipline whatsoever, you get no value in anything. And diets don't work when you don't do them. Exercise doesn't work when you don't do them. But most of the people have some experiences that they want to shift. And once you shift those things, your whole life changes. But life is constant growth. My life isn't here because I went to one seminar one time, and now my life is fit for life. I work out, I train my mind, I train my body. It becomes a lifestyle. It's not just that, like, you're depending upon somebody else. I'm not here to become somebody's guru. I'm not here to give them a gift. I'm here for them to open up their own gifts. And that's really what my life has been.
See, a lot of people have an idea or a dream and they give up on it. No, no, don't do that. Work your dream until it gets hot. See, most things don't happen as soon as we think they should happen. Any number of things can happen to interrupt your flow. It's okay. Don't take it personal. Just acknowledge what's going on. It's called life. And keep on working on your dream. Continue to keep on knocking, keep on knocking. Because this is your life. This is what you love. This is your passion. Step back. Don't judge it. If you judge it, judge not yet, unless ye be judged. Why? Because when you judge it, you invest emotion in it. And that emotion could be anger. And guess what? That hurts you. That doesn't hurt anybody else. One doctor said, the man who angers me killeth me. And then he allowed someone to egg him into an argument on the floor of the National Medical Convention and suffered a massive heart attack. When you're in a state of anger, you have so much acid in your blood, if they withdrew some blood from you and inserted it into a pig, it would die from the acid. So what do you want to take yourself out early for by internalizing things? Shakespeare said, nothing is neither good nor bad, but thinking makes it so. So judge not according to appearances, but right judgment. And feel that everything is going to work out for you. Because you're patient, you're persistent, and you're going to be positive no matter what. Don't allow other things or people or circumstances to determine what your reaction is going to be. So don't allow people to determine how you are going to respond to them or circumstances. Learn to look at it. Look at your life right now.
If you want to keep on getting what you're getting, keep on doing what you're doing. You've got to be willing to change your ways. Your life is working. If you don't like what you have produced, you are director, you are the star, you wrote this script. You produced this, whatever it is. If it's a hit, you produced it. If it's a flop, you produced it. Take ownership of it and decide to go back to the drawing board and rewrite the script that you are the star of. You have the power to do that. On this day, you can declare that I'm going to change. As you look back on your life, you can decide that I don't like what I produced here, and I want higher ground. I want to begin to experience more love. I want to have more adventure in my life. I want something that gives my life a sense of meaning. So we said, let's take an approach. This gives me my life. This might be insane. But I felt so good. I believe, ladies and gentlemen, if we can accept the possibility of that this is the decade of consciousness. That's what I believe that this is. The decade of consciousness, if you please. A time where we can begin to create in folks' minds the idea, the possibility that we can create a more humane society, the possibility that we can create more love, communication, and understanding in relationships, the possibility that we can create a drug-free America, the possibility that we can create the kind of respect for diversity and difference in our multicultural society, the possibility that we can begin to develop the mindset to bring out the best in people, to encourage them to achieve their greatness and support them in their dreams, that if we can, in this decade of consciousness, to begin to see and envision that happening, and that we all can play a role, that we were born for such a time as this, that we showed up for this, that we survived 1 out of 9 million sperms, and we've been chosen for this great work. What an exciting time to be alive. Here's something else to recognize. Wherever you are on the ladder of life, and I was reading in Dr. Norman Vincent Peale's latest book called The Power of Positive Living, which I think is his greatest work. And he has something in there, a section called Comeback Power. Wherever you are in life, ladies and gentlemen, you've got comeback power. I don't care how low you are. I don't care what you have done. I don't care what you have experienced. I don't care how devastated your life might appear to be, the shambles it might be in. There's a power in you that can enable you to be stronger and better than anything that's out here. One man who came to the training, he was not a kid. And I knew he had a drinking problem. And he was looking at me, and I could smell alcohol on him. I said, excuse me, come here, come here, come here. He said, what is it? I said, let me tell you something. I want you to know you've got something in you that's stronger than that poison you're putting in your body. Do you understand me? And he was looking, he was backing up. He said, No. He said, I don't know, man. I said, it is. I said, that's why you're here. Something drew you here. And that which caused you to come, you said you want some help. And you need to be around some people that can help you get in touch with your power, because you know that your life deserves this. See, I think that the reason that we abuse ourselves with drugs and alcohol is that we're trying to numb something in us. That's aching us, that's urging us, that's nagging us to do something bigger and better. It can't be because it tastes so good. It can't be because crack feels so good, or cocaine is not that simple. And when we are deluding ourselves or polluting our minds, it numbs us where we don't have to face reality. Because we don't know what we've got going for us. See, once you discover who you are, the truth of knowing who you are will set you free from ever wanting alcohol, from ever wanting any kind of drug that's going to destroy who you are. Once you begin to know who you are, it will set you free from believing, I can't see myself doing any better. Once you discover this power, this the perfect essence of who you are, that's in all of us, that's permeating our being, that enable us to be the directors of our lives, that you truly can live a healthy, happy, prosperous life, and that you can make it in what are called the worst of times.
But when you decide something is a must for you, an absolute must, when you cut off any possible, you say, I'm going to find the way, or I'm going to make the way. Human beings, When they resolve things, when they make a real resolution inside themselves, which is they raise the standard, they make it a must, they find a way. Think about it in your own life. Haven't you had some area of your life where you raise your standard and your life has never been the same? Maybe at one time in your life you smoked cigarettes, or you did something and you did it for years and you kept trying to change it, and kept telling yourself, I should. And then one day something happened. Something just clicked you over. Something took you over that kind of tipping point. And inside yourself, you said, no more. It was a very, very different experience, wasn't it? Something inside you shifted. And what was a should became a must, and you've never gone back. Getting things is not going to make you happy. That's good news in a tough economy. It's a good reminder. You know, it doesn't matter what you get. It doesn't matter whether it be money or opportunity. All those things might excite you for the moment. You know, even a relationship, as magnificent it may be, might be exciting for a while. But if you don't keep growing, that relationship isn't going to stay exciting. So the secret to real happiness is progress. Progress equals happiness. And if we can make progress on a regular basis, we feel alive. And that's why at the beginning of the year, we get this thing like, okay, I can have this fresh start. I can really do what my soul desires. I can expand. I can grow. I can improve. I can change. Or maybe better than change, I can progress. See, think about that. Progress is an aliveness to it, doesn't it? You don't have to work at changing. People say all the time, now, well, I'm working on changing. Don't worry about it. You don't have to work on changing. Change is automatic. Your body's going to change whether you want it or not as the years go by. And no matter how hard you work, there's going to be some changes going on there. The economy is going to change no matter what you want it to do. The weather is going to change. Relationships are going to change. Everything in life is always changing. We don't have to work on change. Change is automatic, but progress is not.
I believe everything has a vibration. And so everything has an energy, right? And so that I have, without getting too complicated, I have to quiet myself, because when I get quiet, I vibrate at a higher frequency. And so that I can tap into, see, the same thought, the same energy that made this ocean, that made the world, that made you and I have access to that limitless, absolutely perfect thinking in mind. And so the only way that I get that is by getting out of my own way, getting out of my own space, getting out of my own junk. And so I access it for me by getting quiet. The key to my life is that in the morning, and I do it in the morning, it's nice now that I can do it with the ocean here. I also live on a lake. Is I just, it doesn't take a long time. I just take 20 minutes and I access it and I get quiet. And the only way I can access it is to get out of my head. And so I quiet and empty my mind and I access the universe. That's what I do.
How do you create your life?
So I like what he said at the end. Because sometimes, you know, there's things we can't do on, oh, you're so welcome. I'm glad you enjoyed it. I feel like there's some things that we obviously can't do. I mean, we could if we really pushed the bar, but like grounding or different morning things. Like obviously, like I like to work out in the mornings, ideally, you know, crack of dawn, 5 a.m., 5:30, 6. And then come on and do this. But whatever your morning routine is, I love that he mentioned the grounding as well. Just being outside in nature, taking a little walk, clearing your head, getting some exercise are all great things to do. And right before I play the video, I was thinking about gratitude, and actually something came back to my mind that I haven't thought about in a long time. And it was actually... Oh, thank you so much. I wish I could see. I'm going to go on when we do the next thing to see who's writing all of this, but I'm glad you're enjoying this. Just about the gratitude, and it came into my mind about my friend Brad, who just recently passed away, and something that he shared with me, which I never really thought about. And when we're going into why we're grateful for things, and he mentioned to me just like the simplicity of taking a shower, right? And of course, you know, you want to think about running water, but he's like, what if you like thought about like the water that's in the pipe, that's going into the wall, that's going into the ground, like somebody actually built that, you know, and just go, and like, I never thought of that before. Like he really expanded my mind to think about like all that went into what I'm able to experience, or, you know, just like your home, like somebody built this home, you know, it's not like it just appeared out of thin air. So I just thought about him and I was just grateful for that memory. And I wanted to share it with you. So after we play our morning motivational video, we also get into a peak state. Unfortunately, I'm not going to be able to share the music with you guys because it's copyright, I guess, infringement, and it will shut down my whole video. But I will share maybe the visual of the video. And if you want to dance along or play it on your own, today's song is Katy Perry's Roar. I try to pick Tony songs every day, and I just think she's fun, and her videos looks really cool, so I wanted to watch it. And I feel like I haven't watched music videos since I'm a kid, like coming home from school and watching MTV, so this has been really fun to see the videos that go along with the music that we love. So I'm actually going to play this on mute. if you want to dance along. Let me see if I could do that. Maybe I can mute myself. Yeah, let me do that. All right, guys. Well, that is it. that was cool. I really enjoyed that. Hope you have an amazing day. And if you're interested in joining us tomorrow, I usually post the link in the caption or in the feed of our morning routine challenge. And also, if you're interested, just reach out to me for more information. I saw that Val and Cheryl and Pam, along with 10 plus others, were watching. So I appreciate you coming on and checking us out. I love you. Have a good day. We'll see you real soon. Ciao.